as Yamuna, Ganga and their tributaries like Yamuna, Kosi, K-O-S-I, Kosi, Gomti, G-O-M-T-I, Gomti, Ghaggar, G-H-A-G-G-A-R, Ghaggar, and Gandak, G-A-N-D-A-K, Gandak, etc., Gandak, etc. All these rivers are originate from Himalayas. All these rivers originates from Himalayas, originates from Himalayas and perennial in nature. Perennial, those rivers which are filled with water throughout the year. Rivers which are filled with water throughout the year, they are known as the perennial rivers. So let's start up regarding as a first, Ganga. Ganga rises in Garhwal district of Uttarakhand. Garhwal district of Uttarakhand. Garhwal district of Uttarakhand. Ganga originates from Garhwal district of Uttarakhand at an altitude of 6,000 meters. 6,000 meters. The river acquires its name. The river acquires its name after its head streams. After its head streams means when the Ganga, it originates, it generally has originates with the form of a two head streams. Alaknanda, Alaknanda and Bhagirathi, Alaknanda and Bhagirathi, Bhagirathi, Alaknanda and Bhagirathi. On your screens, the picture, figure 3.3 has showing that Alaknanda and Bhagirathi both joined at Devprayag, Rishikesh. Devprayag, Rishikesh. So Alaknanda and Bhagirathi unite at the Devprayag, unite at the Devprayag and known as a Ganga. Flowing southwestward, the Ganga carries out of Himalayas and enters in plains through Haridwar. Ganga leave Himalayas and enter in plains through Haridwar. 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 Ganga enters in plains through Haridwar. Through Haridwar. Clear? So approximately 2,500 kilometers long river, 2,500 kilometers long river finally fall in. It finally fall in. It finally fall in Bay of Bengal. Bay of Bengal. Before fall in Bay of Bengal, Bay of Bengal, this river split into two parts. In West Bengal, this river Ganga split into two parts, two streams, two streams. At the place of Farakka, F-A-R-A-K-K-A. When Ganga reaches in West Bengal, at the place of Farakka, it split into two streams. Farakka, it split into two streams. One stream directly go towards the Calcutta and Bay of Bengal. Another stream moved towards east and enters in Bangladesh. Clear? Bangladesh, where it joined by Padma. Padma is a name of a Brahmaputra in Bangladesh. In Bangladesh, that Ganga River joins the Padma, P-A-D-M-A, Padma, before falling into Bay of Bengal. Before falling into Bay of Bengal. Bay of Bengal, this combined stream, Padma and Ganga, when both are joined in a Bangladesh, they are known as a Jamuna. J-A-M-U-N-A. Yamuna is a tributary of a Ganga and a upper coast, but there as a Jamuna is known to a combined stream of Padma and Ganga. When Padma and Ganga both joined each other in Bangladesh, they are known as Jamuna. J-A-M-U-N-A. Jamuna. Clear? And in Sundarbans, that Jamuna divided into the smaller streams known as Meghna. Known as Meghna. Clear? They are known as the Meghna. They are known as the Meghna. The River Yamuna, Ghaggar, Gandak. River Yamuna, Ghaggar, Gomti, Gandak, Kosi, Ghaggar, Gandak, Kosi. Such rivers are Himalayan origin. These are the Himalayan origin tributaries of Ganga. Himalayan origin tributaries of Ganga. Tributaries of Ganga. These are originates from the Himalayas. Whereas the Chambal, C-H-A-M-B-A-L, Chambal, Son, Cane, Betwa, Damodar are peninsular origin. Damodar, Chambal, Son, Cane, Betwa, and Damodar, these are the peninsular originate rivers. All these are the tributaries of Ganga. Tributaries means tributaries when different small streams, when small streams of water joined together to join larger river is known as tributaries. Yamuna is a tributary of Ganga. Yamuna is a tributary of Ganga. Yamuna is a tributary of Ganga, which originates from Yamunotri Glacier, on the Bandar Panch, B-A-N-D-A-R, Bandar Panch peak near Bandar Panch peak near Garhwal district of Uttarakhand. Ganga originates from the Garhwal district of Uttarakhand from Gangotri Glacier in the form of a two head streams, whereas the Yamuna originates from Yamunotri Glacier on the Bandar Panch peak in Garhwal district of Uttarakhand. It's a 310 kilometers long river. Yamuna is a 310 kilometers long river. 310 kilometers long river, which joins Ganga at Allahabad. Yamuna joins the Ganga at Allahabad. Yamuna joins Ganga at Allahabad. Allahabad. Clear? Which now presently known as a Prayagraj. Allahabad now presently known as Prayagraj. P-R-A-Y-A-G-R-A-G. Prayagraj. Allahabad, where the Yamuna joins Ganga after crossing a 310 kilometers long river, sorry, long distance, it joins Ganga at Prayagraj or Allahabad. Clear? Is that clear? This was as the Ganga river system. Next as the Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra. Brahmaputra river. Brahmaputra river system. Brahmaputra river system. Yes, Gulli.
Sir, can you explain? Sir, we see all these things in regional language. Explain that for me.
Repeat it.
Sir, you are explaining the chapter. So, see, regional language. Explain that for me.
Is there any problem in English? The facts which are related to the matter. Facts which are related to the matter. आपको डाउट कहां पर हुआ? ऑल दीज आर द फैक्ट्स एसोसिएटेड विद द ओरिजिन ऑफ अ रिवर. ओरिजिन ऑफ अ रिवर टिल देयर माउथ. माउथ दैट पार्ट ऑफ अ रिवर वेयर इट फॉल इन अ लार्जर वाटर बॉडी. इन लार्जर वाटर बॉडी जहां रिवर एक लार्जर वाटर बॉडी लाइक एज अ सी, ओशन, बे और गल्फ, इट मर्ज देयर वाटर, इट फॉल देयर वाटर इन अ लार्जर वाटर is known as the mouth of the river. River is generally originates from mountainous areas. Mountainous areas, clear? Mountainous areas. Next is the Brahmaputra river system. Brahmaputra river system. Brahmaputra originates from Mansarovar Lake near Kailash. Mansarovar Lake near Kailash Range. Near Kailash Range. It's 2900 kilometer long river. 2900 kilometers. Total length of a Brahmaputra is a 2900 kilometers long. 2900 kilometers long. Yes, Dhiren.
Sir, please repeat at where the Brahmaputra originates.
Repeat, Brahmaputra or Ganga?
Sir, Brahmaputra originates.
Brahma originates from a Mansarovar Lake near Mansarovar Lake, Tibet, near Kailash. Kailash. Mansarovar Lake, Tibet, Kailash. Yes, Anshia.
Sir, can you tell the length of Ganga River?
Brahmaputra as a 2900 kilometer, Ganga as 2500 kilometers, Yamuna 310 kilometers. 310 kilometers. Yamuna, when it originates from the Yamunotri Glacier in a Garhwal district, from the Bandarpanch peak of a Garhwal district towards the Allahabad, the total length is a 310 kilometers long. Ganga, when it originates from a Garhwal district from Gangotri Glacier towards Bay of Bengal, it's 2500 kilometers long river. 2500 kilometers long river, whereas a Brahmaputra, which originates from a Mansarovar in Tibet, afterwards it starts to flow towards the east, it's 2900 kilometers long river. 2900 kilometers long river. It is one of the largest rivers of the world. Largest river of the world. Brahmaputra is one of the largest rivers of the world. Throughout its course, its whole journey. Throughout its whole journey. In Tibet, it is known as Tsangpo. Tsangpo. Brahmaputra known in Tibet as the Tsangpo. In China, in Tibet, it is known as the Sangpu. Sangpu. Clear? Brahmaputra, when it originates from the Mansarovar, it is known as a Sangpu. In spite of the immense elevation, the Tsangpo flows through Tibet as navigable river through a wide valley. Towards the end of the journey in Tibet, it takes a southward turn in Namcha Barwa. Note it down, highlight it. Namcha Barwa. This is as a mountain peak in north of Arunachal Pradesh. In north of Arunachal Pradesh, there is a mountain peak named as Namcha Barwa. Namchabarwa. When Brahmaputra originates from Mansarovar, it starts to flow towards east. And when it reaches in a Namcha Barwa, it took southward turn and enters in Arunachal Pradesh. It enters in Arunachal Pradesh. Then that Tsangpo River is known as Dihang. In Arunachal Pradesh, this river is known as Dihang. D-I-H-A-N-G. D-I-H-A-N-G. Dihang. D-I-H-A-N-G. Dihang. In Arunachal Pradesh, Dihang joined by the Dibang. D-I-B-A-N-G. D-I-B-A-N-G. Dihang joined by the Dibang River. Dibang is a tributary of a Brahmaputra. D-I-B-A-N-G. When Dihang joined by the Dibang, it is known as a Brahmaputra in Assam. It is known as Brahmaputra in Assam. The Brahmaputra has a braided channel. Remember, in landforms, middle course, we discussed. The Brahmaputra has a braided channel for most of its passage through Assam. With its tributaries, discharging enormous quantities of water and sediments, the river causes disasters during the monsoons. Monsoons, present time period, June, July, August, September, that Brahmaputra River, it resulted as a disaster in Assam. Why? Because world's wettest place, Mausinram, wettest place where the 1200 centimeters annual rainfall recorded, Mausinram in Meghalaya, due to the excessive rainfall, this Brahmaputra River, it is led to the floods in Assam. Clear? So with the name of a Brahmaputra, it flows in Assam and Meghalaya. In Assam and Meghalaya, this river Brahmaputra, it flows with the name of Brahmaputra. In Assam and Meghalaya, this river, which originates from a Mansarovar with the name of Tsangpo, when it enters in Arunachal Pradesh, it is known as a Dihang. When it joined with the Dibang in Arunachal Pradesh, known as a Brahmaputra in Assam and Meghalaya. Done? Then this river, it enters in Bangladesh. Brahmaputra enters in Bangladesh. In Bangladesh. And known as Padma. P-A-D-M-A. Known as Padma. In Bangladesh, this river is known as Padma. When Padma joined by the Ganga, remember, Ganga split into two parts in a Farakka barrage of West Bengal. Then this river joined, Padma joined by the Ganga and known as Jamuna. That river is known as Jamuna, J-A-M-U-N-A. 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 So in Bangladesh, when Padma joined by Ganga is known as Jamuna. That is known as a Jamuna. Jamuna. About 100 kilometers further, downstream flow of this river, it finally start to split into distributaries, which are known as Meghna. Then this river is known as Meghna. When combined stream of Ganga and Brahmaputra, they move towards the Bay of Bengal, it starts to split into the smaller streams. Choti choti nadiyon mein badh jati hai. Such smaller streams are known as Meghna. M-E-G-H-N-A. M-E-G-H-N-A. Meghna. The river Meghna form a very broad. The river Meghna form a very broad and extensive depositional landform named as Sundarbans. The river Meghna forms a very extensive depositional landform named as Sundarbans. Sundarbans. This is as the home of a Bengal tiger. Sundarbans. Clear? Till there any questions? Till there any questions? Yes, Japji?
Sir, in Meghna, the spelling of Meghna is M-E-G-H-N-A.
M-E-G-H-N-A. G. M-E-G-H-N-A. Clear?
And sir, what is the definition of Sundarbans Delta?
Repeat.
Sir, what is the definition of Sundarbans Delta?
So, definition? It's a name of a landform. Sundarbans. Sundarbans as the name of a delta formed by the combined stream of a Brahmaputra and Ganga. Ganga in Bay of Bengal. Sundarbans. I'm repeating again, the Brahmaputra, when it originates from the Mansarovar, it is known as a Sangpo and starts to flow towards the eastward. When it reaches in a Namcha Barwa, it took southward turn and enters in Arunachal Pradesh, where this river is known as a Dihang. Dihang joined by the Dibang, D-I-B-A-N-G, D-I-B-A-N-G. Then that combined stream of a river is known as a Brahmaputra in Assam and Meghalaya. Afterwards, this stream, it enters in a Bangladesh known as a Padma. When Padma joined by the Ganga, it is known as Jamuna, J-A-M-U-N-A. And finally, Jamuna, when it starts to split into the smaller streams, distributaries, they are known as a Meghna, M-E-G-H-N-A, Meghna. It makes as the world's largest delta, Sundarbans. Yes, Janvi. Jia, Is that clear? Now next has a Sikkim river system, peninsula river system. Yes, Jia.
Sir, जो आपने third old stage लिखवाई थी river की.
Yes.
उसमें आपने सिर्फ delta लिखवाया था. Estuary distributaries भी करनी है ना?
हाँ हो गई. अच्छा नहीं हुई. Okay.
No.
Okay. Well, let's finish it that. Third course of a river, delta we discuss. Thank you, Jia. Delta we discuss. Two were remaining. Distributaries also done with the delta. Distributaries when the river start to split into the smaller streams of water at its mouth, they are known as the distributaries. Distributaries. River is there. Main river is there. River, when it reaches at its mouth, it starts to split into the smaller streams of water. Such smaller streams are known as distributaries. These are known as distributaries. Distributaries. Distributaries means when river reaches at its mouth, mouth, जहां रिवर का एंड हो रहा है माउथ when river reaches at its mouth it starts to split into smaller streams known as distributaries and the gaps in between of our distributaries filled by the sediments deposited sediments known as a delta clear Example of a distributaries are Hugli of Ganga. Hugli is the distributary of Ganga. Hugli. Hugli is the distributary of Ganga. Clear? Hugli is the distributary of Ganga. Is that clear, everybody? This is as the landforms, two landforms remaining from the third course of river. Last as the estuary. Estuary, E-S-T-U-A-R-Y, estuary, estuary, estuary is the, estuary is the, estuary is the, estuary is the, funnel shaped structure formed by the river at its mouth when river fall in rocky surfaces rocky rocky surfaces when river fall in rocky surfaces instead they have narrow, gradually widening bay is known as estuary. This is as a river. In a delta, river starts to split into the smaller streams, but in estuary, river water directly fall into the larger water body, sea or ocean. Example, Narmada and Tapi rivers. Narmada and Tapi rivers fall in Arabian Sea. Fall in Arabian Sea through estuaries. Clear? Estuary is a funnel-shaped structure. Funnel-shaped structure formed by the river at its mouth. When river fall in rocky surfaces, instead of narrow and gradually widening bay. Example, Narmada and Tapi forms estuaries when they fall in Arabian Sea. Understood? Anybody else? Any other question?